Oh, he's got himself into such more than a spot of trouble, hasn't he, over the weekend. Ashish Nandi, well-known sociologist and now the most controversial person perhaps in the country, joins me from Delhi. Sanjay Roy, organizer of the Jaipur Literary Festival from Jaipur. Sudhinder Bhadauria of the Bahujan Samaj Party from Delhi. Dr. Lata Priya Kumar, member of the National Commission for Scheduled Castes, is joining us from Chennai. And Kancha Elaiya is a well-known Dalit activist, an academic. He joins us from Jaipur as well. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Ashish Nandi, you don't seem to be in any mood to apologize, are you? You're not taking back your comments, you're explaining your comments.
I did apologize because I'm really unhappy. I'm unhappy that I have heard the sentiments of so many, but they have been fed the news in a particular way.
Have you been forced to retract? Tell me, are you forced to retract? Are you doing it openly from the bottom of your heart only to avoid yourself some trouble?
No, not at all that. You know, it's true that many people have been hurt and the sentiments have been hurt. And I do feel that it may not be my fault, but they have been hurt. And I'm sorry for that.
Do you believe you're factually incorrect?
They have been inadvertent.
With all respect, Ashish Nandi, and I have great regard for
you. I was not making a factual comment at all there. But even there, I would say that, you know, I would say on the whole, I may be proved right if you take into account everyday small corruption, you know, people paying extra to get into a
Why do you link corruption and caste? Why do you link corruption and caste? Corruption perpetuated by any caste is wrong and there is no justification for it. You seem to offer an alibi for people to be corrupt.
Yes, I do.
Why?
I do. I do because I think people who are at the margin of desperation, should have more leniency. From both the state
and the
constitution and the law.
Ashish Nandi, I'm going to open this up for debate in a minute. But I think that, you know, you are, with respect, you're tying yourself up in knots because you say you do believe that zero corruption society in India will be a despotic society. In other words, you are trying to say that corruption is necessary for a just and equitable society.
No, corruption is not necessary, but trying to bring corruption down to zero is a prescription for despotism, because there is only one zero corruption society to the best of my knowledge in this world, and that is Singapore.
What if I prove here on News Hour tonight that you are contradicting yourself?
No, I'm not contradicting myself.
Then I'd like to quote Ashish Nandi.
Corruption, ma'am.
I'd like to quote Ashish Nandi to Ashish Nandi. Can I quote Ashish Nandi to Ashish Nandi? Ashish Nandi, April 2012. We need a second freedom movement to get rid of corruption and its perpetrators. Ashish Nandi, April 2011, corruption rots the whole system. Ashish Nandi, April 2010, quoted in the Economic Times, that the system that encouraged people to be corrupt, corruption has spread because of the way polity has spanned out in the last 150 years. The only way is to improve the system to make it more transparent. You have been a very vocal critic of the endemic corruption in our society.
Yes.
So on a platform of a literary festival, you are trying to be rhetorical. You draw in caste. You seem to be justifying corruption as an equalizer in society. Intellectually, your argument may be interesting, but only at that level. Only as some kind of an intellectual argument, perhaps to stoke a debate on a literary festival panel, but not as a statement of fact.
You see, in United States, all race riots have been started by colored people in recent years. But no American thinks of taking a revenge by organizing a race riot. No white American thinks that way, because the idea has got into the mind of them that the blacks, because of their past, because of the kind of oppression and exploitation and violence they have seen over two centuries, have been at the receiving end of the system, and because they are rioting partly in reaction to that past, that consideration has come. And I'm not talking of having separate laws for the backward classes. I'm talking of a public consciousness.
You are saying
that they should have at least
No, you are saying Ashish Nandi, you are actually saying, should I open this up to debate? I actually should open this up to all our panelists. Let's get our panelists in. In your clarification, you say that if a particular kind of corruption exists among the SCs, STs and OBCs, you have hope for the Indian Republic. My question today is, why should corruption be seen as an equalizer, be looked on for hope? Are we a meritocratic society or are we making an argument for greater corruption? Is that a kind of message which Ashish Nandi should have sent out? I'd like to get a first response from Kancha Elaiya. Kancha Elaiya, your response to what Ashish Nandi says here, or has said and is also saying on the course of this debate.
Well, see, I have been there in that session where Ashish spoke, and we have been friends for quite a long time. I think that Ashish has deployed the word corruption to a section of people who should not have been deployed of that kind of a word. See, take for example SC, ST, OBCs. For 3,000 years have been suppressed, oppressed, exploited. They were more or less equal to that of the slaves. Now, how can slaves be corrupt? Now, if we were to say that the upper caste have been corrupt for 3,000 years, established a corrupt system, they are coming into it now through the same means, that would have been different. Now, this does not mean that, this legal course is or it should
be arrested. 1 minute.
In the morning
no, itself Kancha, said nothing. Kancha Elaiya, would you object?
Is,
no, Kancha Elaiya, would you object if Ashish Nandi had said that most of the corrupt are from the upper caste? Would you object to that?
Yeah, that I definitely object, because, see, how is he defining corruption? What is the notion of corruption that he is deploying on SC, ST, OBCs? Is he trying to say that SC, ST, OBCs can come into system only through corruption? Does it mean that he is also defining reservation within the structure of corruption that he is defining? That is the only way that majority of
Ashish
the SCST
Nandi, would you respond to that?
Come into the democratic system.
Ashish,
so what is his understanding of that?
Ashish Nandi, respond to him. You say, and I'm quoting this for our viewers, he says, Ashish Nandi says, quote, it is a fact that most of the corrupt come from the OBCs and the scheduled castes and now increasingly the scheduled tribes. And as long as this is the case, Indian Republic will survive. I leave it to the intelligence of our news hour viewers on whether Ashish Nandi is actually making a case for corruption. What is the point you are trying to make, Ashish Nandi? Kancha Elaiya is throwing that challenge to you. Please respond to him.
I am proposing that we pay some attention to the way the system has been exploited by the rich and the powerful, and therefore those sections of the society which have been pushed to the margin of desperation also have a right, to some extent, not fully perhaps, but to some extent have the right to exploit the system.
No,
similarly.
So you are saying,
and if today the Dalits have put up the first unrecognized billionaire, dollar billionaire in India, it shows that Dalits also are...
No, but Ashish Nandi, is that a...
To produce
no,
Ashish,
quota.
Ashish, you know, Arunab, let me ask a question straight to Ashish. So, see, Ashish, don't you think that, see, you are a psychologist and socio-psychologist. If you are also bracketing the people who are coming up from the bottom of the society, climbing each ladder with a great difficulty, that they too are corrupt, and in a context of this whole corruption debate in the nation, Anna Hazare and Kejriwal, all these people are talking about corruption. What would be the impact, psychological impact of these masses who are coming into the system? Don't they get...
No, Mr. Kancha Elaiya, allow me to, with all respect, to drive the contours of this debate. I like to be direct. I'm not a theoretical person. My question, I don't want to over-intellectualize what has been said here. Let other channels do it. My question is simple. Mr. Ashish Nandi, will you say A. Raja is a Dalit? So all the charges he faces, criminal conspiracy, forgery, prevention of corruption act, are a response to the inequities of Indian society? Would you say if there are alleged financial irregularities by Mayawati, it is a response to the inequities of society? Will you also say that to the prime accused in the 4,000 crore mining scam Madhu Koda, on which Times Now is doing an expose today, that this is necessary corruption? This corruption is necessary.
No,
would you say
necessary.
That?
Because it is not necessary, but it is understandable.
Understandable.
Necessary. I am saying it is little bit more understandable than the corruption.
Sir, understandable.
Of the
Why are you mixing caste and corruption? I just told you that the three comments of yours, which were quoted in the national and international media, were in the backdrop of the 2G scam. At that point of time, you had a different line. Now you are saying that what Raja has done is understandable because of his caste.
Different line. I mean, I don't get my transcripts of my interviews mailed to me. Otherwise, I would have probably not passed one or two of them, because I have always held that this, if you read my Sachar lecture, only given a few months ago, you would have find the same tone there. This point has been made there.
No, sir, this
probably more sophisticated.
Well,
Similarly, in the Ambedkar lecture given few months ago, also the same.
Sir, my point. I want to get in. I want to get in. Dr. Lata Priya Kumar, Ashish Nandi. You know, your comments are very controversial. When you are saying that corruption by D. Raja would be understandable on account of his caste, Dr. Lata Kumar, your views on the larger point that have been made by Ashish Nandi, and any question you'd like to ask him, please.
Yeah, first I would deplore the statement made by Ashish Nandi, which was which painted all the SC, ST and OBCs with the same paintbrush, and it was most uncalled for. And even now I'm not able to comprehend what he's trying to say. Is now after Mr. Elaya said about the rich and the powerful and how the SCs and the STs have been oppressed and suppressed for more than 3,000 years. And now he comes up with the, it is the rich and the powerful and the upper caste who have oppressed, and they have been doing this. So I really can't comprehend what he is trying to say, what he is trying to imply. And just as terrorism cannot be painted in the with the brush of religion and caste, similarly, you cannot paint corruption with the same paintbrush with the other communities. So there are individual cases where the court is taking its... So I can't comprehend what Mr. Nandi is trying to put forth.
I do think there is a relationship between social hierarchy and corruption. I don't think corruption is a caste-neutral phenomenon. I do believe that in the case of those at the bottom of the society, some corruption, at least a large number of small corruption, is a matter of desperation and survival.
Well, I want
in
to
fact,
get in
very great soft corner for that.
What are the means for them to be corrupt if they are so way down in the social hierarchy? I mean, do they have the means to be corrupt at all?
There are no means. But yes. You look at the way in the NREGA scheme that even to get the daily allowance, they have to bribe. Is it not corruption?
Daily allowance from where?
That kind of corruption is the corruption of the desperate. For the payment.
So
of
who
the,
is being corrupt?
Days,
Mr. Nandi, please. Who is being corrupt?
Money is extracted, but the courts have to pay.
Other than SC, SCs and the oppressed classes?
The bribe is being paid by the landless laborers often. And technically, it is also corruption.
Well,
but I am suggesting that corruption is actually a corruption. This is survival league.
Well, I